you're listening to this, if someone's listening to this right now and they're kind of on the fence of bringing in agentic AI, when do the costs make sense?
I think number one is we should absolutely be having a conversation around return on investment anytime we're considering AI now, right? I think a lot of these organizations that we've worked with and specifically out there in the media have tried that particular process, which is they've gone to the whiteboard, they've understood the capability of generative AI, they've done the sticky board exercise to say, here's the five or six things we're going to use this for, but they haven't actually gone into production. And one of the major reasons for that is because they've not thought through the lens of return on investment and scale. Very quickly, you start thinking about, okay, well, how do I then take a process like in the HR space? And how can I do things like reduce costs? How can I reduce technical debt? How can I then send the productivity that the employees and the managers previously were spending through passing through different systems and data and now reinvesting their time somewhere else? So one of the ways that we do this is we start to think about it through the context of value and ROI. I actually do this to my own work actually pretty actively right now, which is I take a step back and I say, okay, what have I worked on in the last week? How much time have I allocated to a certain specific set of tasks? And how can we refocus that by then doing things like having conversations like, well, what can I automate today? And now how can I focus on different work as a result of it? So I think in the age of generative AI and now specifically in the world of agents, one of the things we have to be really thoughtful as we think about ROI is how much time are we spending on particular tasks, tasks that we actually don't want to be delivering that are highly manual? And how can we now think about reinvesting our time and efforts somewhere else? And we do that at scale all the time, and we call it our value methodology at IBM.
So those manual processes, manual tasks, the tedium that exists in practically every job, I don't think people talk enough about when you get rid of that tedium, you're opening up the door for your engineers, for anyone who's working, to actually not just breathe, but have more like ability to do other things that will bring that return. Is that calculated in the return on investment when you talk about it?
Absolutely. Yeah. So we kind of call that cost avoidance, and the aspect of that is productivity. So the way I think about this is very, very simple. We want to make small teams feel like big teams. There's too much of the discussion right now that talks about making big teams feel like smaller teams. But actually, if we think about the net new insights that you can get through this particular technology, you can actually build scale and make teams you're much more scaled as a result of it. So good example of this at IBM, and we had a small team that were specifically working on learning class management. So their role was to essentially watch when we had one class open with five people and one class open with two people, but the actual class could take seven people. So they were actually specifically working on how do you then invite these two people to go to that other team's learning class, and how do we then make that full, and how do we then cancel that other class, etc. All of that work there is just busy work. Yeah. It's just moving one hand to the other. And what we're able to do was to use agents then to actually outsource a lot of that work. So the learning class manager is now spending time on the best quality content to deliver in the session and not moving one hand to the other.